your busy schedule.
Thank you for having me.
How long did it take you to drive here?
Not too bad, like about 45 minutes.
Nothing for LA.
Nothing for LA, no.
So you grew up in Bregenz, in Austria, and you were playing the trumpet, and now you're here in Los Angeles. What brought you to Los Angeles?
For me, it was certainly the love for music, especially contemporary music. And I grew up in Austria as a small boy playing the trumpet and going through all the Blasmusik and conservatory. And then I went to the University for Music and Performing Arts in Vienna and I studied classical music there and music production. The capital of Austria,
big
yes.
City.
And then from there, I always had sort of an interest in contemporary music, popular music, film music, and all the things I would listen to and all the records I would get, it always said produced or recorded in Los Angeles. Mm-hmm. So it was sort of a natural progression for me to be curious and look into the options to go and actually come and check it out, you know? So that's initially why I had the desire to come to the United States and especially Los Angeles.
LA is the city of music, entertainment music, pop music. It's far away from Austria though, and yet we have so many Austrians here. So what do you think brings Austrians and Austrian musicians to Los Angeles?
I think one of the main reasons is that Los Angeles has such a pull of different, you know, styles of music from all over the world. Movie studios, record companies, they are all located here in Los Angeles and in Hollywood. So there's a natural sort of desire for people that want to be in that line of work to come here and be close to the action, so to speak. And I think it's also necessary in order to work in that environment, to be close to that environment.
So Los Angeles, we heard, is the city, one of the cities of music, but it's also very competitive. Only the best can succeed. How do you deal with that?
Well, I personally think that competitiveness is actually a good thing for a creative person. I think when you first come here, it's certainly overwhelming because there's so many people here and the industry is very big. But at the same time, it's very small. It just means that there's a lot of people doing the same thing and doing the same thing very well, meaning that the people that collaborate together, they kind of stick to each other.
Mm-hmm. They know
so
each other.
The passion is what brings you here, but then the competition and the level of talent that is constantly changing here, I think makes you grow as an artist. It makes you look over your shoulder and be like, oh wow, what's this person doing? What can he do? Can I learn something? At least for me, that was like one of the very inspiring things about this place, because you had so many opportunities to look at other people, be very creative in your own field, but also in a lot of other fields.
And now you work as a freelancer, you have your own business.
Correct.
Like many other people in Los Angeles.
Yes.
Give me an example of what you do.
I'm kind of a one-man show. A typical day for me can be like I wake up in the morning, I have a cup of coffee, and I put on a bathrobe, and I go into the studio, and I write down some ideas on the piano, and then I record some of them, and then I mix them, and I put them into a format that I can send to people, be it through the internet, or personally deliver a CD somewhere. And then I take feedback, and I collaborate with people, and hopefully then all those things end up in a project that then gets released and everybody else in the world gets to enjoy.
Sounds like a very beautiful, relaxed day, but we both know that it's very hard. You have to be a hardworking person to succeed in LA. Gerrit, I have been here as the Consul General of Austria for 3.5 years and I met numerous Austrians who are successful here. You are one of them. Have you ever had the opportunity of working with a very famous person?
I have, yes. I've worked with many different people that are well known on different projects, but probably the best known would be the singer and actress Cher, who lives just 20 minutes from here, actually, in Malibu on the coast. She creates a lot of her music, and a lot of her concerts are created in Los Angeles and then go from here to inspire people all around the world. I was part of the pre-production side of that, meaning putting together the sounds for her shows, mixing some of the stuff, choosing some of the arrangements.
I mean, we do have Austrians living here who are known all over the world, like Arnold Schwarzenegger, for example, mm-hmm. or Wolfgang Puck, mm-hmm. the chef who is catering for the Oscars right. every year. They call him Wolfgang Puck here.
Yeah.
I guess they would still understand if we said Wolfgang Puck. Or Christoph Waltz, he's also living right. here. But we also have a lot of Austrians like yourself who are very successful here, but not yet that well known. Do you know any of these Austrians?
I actually do. I know a lot of Austrians based on the beautiful events that you host through your work
with the Consulate General.
And there's a lot of people that work here that aren't in front of the camera, that aren't, you know, constantly photographed, but that contribute a great amount to the arts or sciences or, you know, research and all those different yes. fields. It's yeah. always very interesting to see how different people engage with their environment. And I think LA has a very inspiring environment for a lot yes, of Austrians abroad.
It definitely does. So as you said, we do have Austrians in research here at the Getty Center. We do have lawyers teaching at UCLA. We have musicians.
Architects.
We have artists, architects.
Yeah.
Yes. A lot of Austrians.
So it's
here.
A very eclectic crowd of people that do live in this town.
Makes me very happy, of course, as the Consul General of Austria mm-hmm. in Los Angeles, if my Austrian fellows work together and help each other.
Yeah, it's a great thing.
Gerrit, thank you so much for coming. Thanks for letting me have an insight into what you do and what brought you here and what your profession is all about. I wish you a lot of success
thank
for the
you.
Future. And I'm looking forward to seeing you at one of our upcoming events at the Consulate General.
I'm looking forward to it very much.